time to come to the masjid, and this is the time to do the tarawih, and this is the time to make ijtihad in ibadah. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم إذا جاء في العشر الأواخر قام الليل وشد المنظر وأيقظ أهله للصلاة ورد عليه الصلاة والسلام. He was when the last 10 days of Ramadan come, he used to support his back with some clothes and he would stay up all night praying. He wake up his family. Because these are the 10 nights that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. When he said, وَالْفَجْرُ وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ. Those are the last 10 nights of Ramadan that are blessed with the existence of Laylatul Qadr among them. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, "Uritu Laylatul Qadri thumma unsituha." I was shown which night is the night of power. Then I was made to forget it. فَالْتَلِسُوهَا سِلْتَ الْعَرْشِ الْأَوَاثِرِ. Seek it in the odd number nights of the last 10 days of 10 nights of Ramadan. طيب, I'm going to talk about something different though today because somebody called me and I usually like to talk about real issues and real problems that that we face. We know, brothers and sisters, that da'wah ila Allah is one of the greatest khayr that we can do. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, la yahdi Allah lika rajulan khayrun laka mimma tala'at alayhi shams. It is better for you to invite somebody to Islam than owning everything that the sun shines on. That is the whole life. And alhamdulillah, I would say that, generally speaking, most of us are aware of da'wah and making da'wah and the importance of making da'wah. But I want to ask myself and you a question. Of normally what happens after we invite somebody to Islam and he and she accepts. In many cases, we think that we have reached our goal, and that's it, that is all that is required of us. Somebody became a Muslim, alhamdulillah, he makes a shahada in front of people after Friday, and he makes takbir, and then he goes home, and then we go home. What happens after that, in many cases, you know, might not be pleasant. If you are empathetic and you put yourself in the shoes of that person who just abandoned his religion, his old religion, and in many cases that is going to cause him a loss, at least at the social level. His family might become against him or her, he or she might lose their